Hi everyone, this is Shweta Shukla, owner of Creations and Flavors. Again, I have come up with my DIY project. In this video, I'm going to teach you how you can enhance the look of your old ceramic planter. After teaching you the planter making, I'll just tell you how you can do indoor gardening, like what kind of soil you need to use for indoor gardening and what is the care, what is the precaution you can take for indoor gardening. So it is my kind request to watch full video because a lot of information I am going to share with you all. And if you like my channel, please don't forget to subscribe it, like my video, share it, and do comment in the comment section of whatever video, whatever DIYs you want me to do in future. And if you face any kind of problem regarding getting the material or regarding making this DIY, please ask me. I'll try to help you out. So let us start. For this project, we need one plain planter, ceramic planter. I'm going to use silver and gold color 3D outliners. If you want, you can use glass outliners also. Glass colors, I'm using water based. If you want, you can use solvent based also, because I'm quite allergic, so I prefer for water based glass colors. Masking tape, design sheet, yellow carbon. Now take your yellow carbon, this glossy side you have to keep like this. Take your design sheet, and with the help of masking tape, you have to fix it. Now this is the time to trace the design. So here I am done with my tracing part. Now it's time to outline the design. So take your 3D outliner and outline the complete design. Very carefully you have to do because glass colors are in liquid form, so they will flow outside if you keep any gap in your outlining. Now I'm done with my outlining part. Just leave it for 15 minutes, and after that it's time to fill the colors. So I'm using a red glass color. Very carefully you have to fill the colors and make sure there should be no bubble. If you get any bubble, just break it with the help of toothpick or your pen, any sharp thing. So here I am done with my work. See how beautiful it is looking. So traditional, and it is really very good for gifting purpose also. After coloring, after completing this, I have given 2 coats of Mod Podge to make the color permanent and to seal the colors. So if you don't want to use Mod Podge, you can go for varnish. Now it's time to plant something in this pot. So now I'm going to plant jade in this. Jade basically belongs to the succulent family, and it's a very, basically it's not 100% indoor plant. It's a very good option for like semi-shade kind of plant. We can put these kind of plants near our window, and daily 2 to 3 hours of sunlight is required for jade, for any kind of succulent. 3 to 4 hours sunlight is required. It's really very hardy plant, and it's very easy to propagate and maintain this plant. So if you are a beginner in indoor gardening or a balcony gardening, I will suggest you to go with these kind of hardy plants.
For now, let's talk about the soil mix. Whenever we are dealing with any kind of succulents or any kind of indoor plants, just make sure your soil is really very porous. It should not hold a lot of water. So this I have taken the mixture of our garden soil, cocoa pit and sand. Your sand should be always river sand, not the sea sand, okay, because river sand is very good for the plants. This is the mixture of bone meal and neem cake. Bone meal is really very good for the succulents, and you need water and some pebbles to decorate. Mix all the ingredients together and then start potting. So for any kind of gardening, when you are selecting a pot, you should have hole. This is must. Okay, so to cover these holes, I'm using piece of stones gravels. Okay, now it's time to I am putting the soil mix. Once you start indoor gardening or your balcony gardening, really you will enjoy. And jade is considered to be luckiest plant according to Vastu and Feng Shui. So it's quite interesting if you make your own planter and if you plant a jade and give to someone who is really close to you. So I'm done. Just leave some part and press it properly so that there should be no air pockets inside. Now just I want to put some stones here, and you know, I don't want some stem, so I'll just cut it and I'll just propagate. See, this is a small jade plant which I propagated from its stem. You can even propagate this jade with its leaves also. It's very easy to do, very easy. So these are the few parts which I cut, and I'll just put it in the soil. I've taken one inch. It's very easy to propagate. So from one plant we can make, you know, many plants. And even you can put leaves also like this. It will grow. So I've taken mother plant, I shifted mother plant from this to this, and again I'll grow many plants from the mother plants. Now it's time to water. While watering any kind of succulent, just make sure don't water them every day. And when you are watering, the water should come outside from the hole. See, it is coming out. So now I'll water this plant after 5 to 6 days. It depends upon your climatic condition, the city where you are living. The best thing is just remove these pebbles and check if soil is really very dry, till 1-1.5 inches. It means ki it is ready to water. If there is any moisture inside your pot, please don't water your succulent, because the succulents, they have lot of water in their leaves. They contain lot of water in the leaves, any plant from the succulent family. So they don't die if you really water them very less, but if you water them more, they may die. Okay, so this is the main thing, and they don't need lot of fertilizer and lot of care. It's very easy to maintain. So I hope you all are going to plant this.
I hope you all liked it. Please like and share my video. It always motivates me to do more and more. Thank you so much.